The following is a special presentation of the National Lacrosse League.
The National Lacrosse League just announced that they made the decision to cancel their plans to start in April with a shortened season and will instead look ahead to a full 2021-2022 season. Joining me now is Commissioner Nick Sakiewicz. Nick, can you start by just telling us what your message is to the fans?
Yeah, obviously, extremely disappointed. We're still in very challenging and uncertain times. And for really reasons beyond our control, we just couldn't pursue the 2021 season. Really appreciate all the support. We'll continue to grow, you know, the league, and we'll continue to put our best efforts. But there was just too much in our way to be able to overcome in order to get the season back going again. So just want to thank everybody that was involved, all the fans, the sponsors, the broadcast partners. Everybody's been great. Really appreciate all the support.
A lot of other leagues found a way to play, whether it was a bubble, shortened season, what have you. So I think a lot of fans will be wondering what happened with the NLL.
Our goal was to play, clearly. And we've been working literally 24/7, 7 days a week. The staff is really exhausted from this effort. But unfortunately, there were just too many factors that went against us here, Devin. The most recent enhanced travel restrictions that came out on Friday of last week, making it impossible to cross the Canadian border, made the challenge just impossible for us to execute against. Those restrictions go into force this week. When we analyzed the situation, including the calendar, the pandemic circumstances, and the resources required, there was just too much uncertainty to make it happen. And quite frankly, there's unique factors at play with the NLL, including the fact that 70% of our players live in Canada, and most of them have other work obligations there. Those factors are different than any other league. We're not like the other leagues where players live in their own markets, and our players fly in for games from many other places and have to cross borders, and it just made it very, very difficult. And it would require players to quarantine in situations where they weren't able to quarantine. So, moreover, the league's revenue requires fans in the arena as well. So, in some cases, you've seen other leagues talking about the huge amounts of money that they're losing as a result of, lost revenues. And in our league, the proportion of our revenue is even more dependent on live events. So it's really overall disappointing, but the circumstances were such where we just couldn't move players around and we couldn't cross borders.
Now, there was a bubble scenario on the table. Can you kind of take us through what that scenario was and what challenges it presented to the league?
We were planning a fantastic made-for-TV event at First Ontario Centre in Hamilton. They were incredible folks to work with. The Spectrum management team over there were working with us hand in hand to put together a made-for-TV event in spectacular fashion. We had deals on the table to air that event across Canada and the United States on both digital and linear platforms. We were investing heavily into lots of really great technologies that were going to be a part of this made-for-TV event, and frankly, some best practices and technologies that we're going to kick to next year and utilize showcasing next year's season. And it was going to be a really exciting event to be played in early April, but again, we just were unable to pull it off.
The NLL stopped playing in March of 2020, so we are about to be, by the time we return to play next fall, on a 20-month hiatus. That obviously presents, massive challenges for a professional league. What is the outlook for the future of the NLL after this?
Not only will the NLL come back in the fall, but it's going to thrive and expand. You saw us announce a new franchise in the middle of the summer with Fort Worth coming on board. We will have another franchise announcement in 2021 for sure. certainly before we start our next season. We made announcements with great partners like Fanatics and, you know, other deals coming down the line. So we're all very excited about the NLL and where it's going, and can't wait to get back to play. And we're turning our attention and our focus on next season, which will begin soon. Actually, 8-9 months goes by pretty quickly.
Have you or the league spoken to the players, and what was their reaction?
Yeah, we actually have been speaking with the players every day, I think, almost, it seems like every day. They've been awesome to work with, Zach Currier and Reed Reinholdt, the two executives now that are running the Players Association, have been incredible partners through this whole process. And as you see, they're quoted in our release and have been very supportive along the way. So we really appreciate the players. They've been fantastic to work with so far. We feel like we've got a real partnership with the Players Association now. And this decision was really made in lockstep with them.
Obviously, as you touched on, a long hiatus like this brings up some concerns about the businesses behind the National Lacrosse League. Obviously, you know, some talk will arise about franchises folding. What do you have to say to that?
There's no franchises folding. We have fantastic owners across the entire league. The league's been shored up really with nothing but blue chip owners from top to bottom. Everybody is very bullish on the future of the National Lacrosse League. Like I said, we may be the only league in the world to have announced not one, but potentially two expansion teams during the pandemic. That's not a league that's going away. That's a league that's thriving and getting stronger. We've learned a lot during this process. And a lot of those learnings are going to make us a bigger and better league going forward. So, you know, we don't even think about teams folding. We're adding teams, not folding teams.
Sticking with the business side of things, but kind of moving over to sponsorships and ticket sales, are there any issues that have or will arise with this hiatus with that side of things?
Well, the fans have been awesome. The sponsors have been awesome every step of the way. We're hearing a lot of data and a lot of metrics from other leagues and other sports entertainment properties where the vast majority of their fans are continuing to hang in there, and they're rolling their season tickets over. They're rolling their money over to when the leagues and the teams can start playing again. And the NLL is no different. We have fantastic fans, loyal fans. They're hanging in there with us, and they just want to see us get back to play. And, you know, this decision that's been made is really a decision in the best interests of everyone, players, fans. At the end of the day, you know, everybody's been really supportive.
I want to touch on expansion again, because I know there's been a plan years in the making with the NLL to continue expanding. So do you and the league plan to keep pushing forward with that as aggressively as you have been?
Well, there's a lot of interest in the NLL and lacrosse in general. Lacrosse is a booming sport at the grassroots level. In the United States here, it's exploding. Reminds me a lot of soccer in the 80s when I played and the sport was booming. Lacrosse in Canada is a historical, legendary sport that's been around for 150 years and continues to grow at the grassroots level. So there is no shortage of owners that want in our league. We have more interested parties that want in our league than we have franchises to give them. We can't expand, you know, more than one, maybe two. We expanded two teams at once before. Not sure we're going to do that again. So there's a limitation on the number of teams that can't come into the league. But I will tell you, there is no limit. I was talking to a finance person today saying there's a lot of investment capital. They call it dry powder. I don't know why, but they call it dry powder sitting on the sidelines waiting to be invested. And there's a lot of people that have targeted the National Lacrosse League for investment. So we're really excited about that dynamic. There's a demand out there. There's a lot of investors that specifically go into emerging sports, and we're an emerging sport. So we're excited about it.
Now, lastly, how confident are you that there will in fact be a season come the fall?
We have an incredible army of doctors, team doctors, led by some excellent experts in the space. And we're extremely confident that not only will we have a season, but that the lessons that we've learned here in the last 11 months and the strategies that we've developed actually makes our league better and our business better. So we're pretty excited about that and very confident. And we're back at work today planning the launch of our season in the fall.
All right. Well, thank you, Commissioner Nick Sakiewicz. Appreciate your time.
You bet. Thanks, Devin.